The 2012 winner of the Heisman Memorial Trophy is Johnny Manziel.
December 8, 2012. It was a special day to be an Aggie. Happy holidays, Brazos Valley, and welcome to Manziel's Road to the Heisman. With Cody Coyle, I'm Daryl Bruffett.
Just like last year when Robert Griffin III won the Heisman at Baylor, Johnny Manziel's run came out of nowhere to vault him into college football history.
When the Aggies started August camp, there was no starting quarterback name. Johnny Manziel was in the running, but talked about as a work in progress.
He was named the starter 2 weeks before the season got underway, but because he was a redshirt freshman, was deemed off limits to the media. That's a Kevin Sumlin mandate. So if Johnny can't talk, we did the next best thing. Took a road trip to the Hill Country to find out more about this kid that had picked up the nickname Johnny Football.
The legend of Johnny Football begins in the Texas Hill Country, Kerrville to be exact, where Manziel mania got its start. Stuart Cunyus writes and shoots photos for the Hill Country Community Journal, and he'll never forget the first time he saw Manziel take the field.
I photograph games and I watch games through the lens, and his first game out here as a freshman, I kept putting the camera down and just he kept amazing me with the things that he was doing, and you forget to shoot because it was like, oh my gosh, this guy's from another world.
The numbers Manziel put up from the time he began his varsity career as a sophomore to the time he graduated, simply amazing. 160 combined touchdowns, 77 his senior season alone, over 11,000 yards, and he twice led the Antlers to the state semifinals.
I get a kick out of the sportscaster saying, well, he had 6 touchdowns the other day. We really never expected anything less from him. He got us so spoiled. 6, 7, he ran for 8 touchdowns once against Clemens here, so... He's just an amazing athlete, the best I've ever seen.
Against SMU, Manziel broke 2 Aggie freshman records and tied another. Judge Steve Abels has been the public address announcer at Antler Stadium for 23 years, and he was not a bit surprised by what he saw Johnny do in Dallas.
We were convinced that he was going to do the same thing at A&M that he did at Tyvee, which was just electrify people. You had people that would go to Tyvee games that were 75, 80 years old, and they go just to see Johnny because of his ability to run, pass, and lead. Just spectacular at high school, but we were all convinced he was going to do the same thing at A&M.
Mark Smith was Manziel's coach at Tyvee and now is the head coach at Converse Judson. He knew Johnny was a fantastic athlete when he and his family moved to Kerrville as an 8th grader. Now he's proud of how much better Manziel has become as a quarterback.
I think that's where I saw him grow the most between his junior and senior year. His junior year, he made a lot of plays with his feet. His senior year, he learned to just have patience, let things happen, and he made a lot more plays with his arm. And I think he did a lot of that in a process to grow, but also to show that he could throw the football. Everybody knew he could run it, but could he throw it? He's got a very live arm. So I think I'm seeing some of the same things with him now.
In Aggieland, Manziel Madness has spawned the nickname Johnny Football. Now, the story would be a whole lot better if Manziel had been Johnny Football while building his legend in high school. But the truth is, the nickname seems to be an Aggie invention.
Well, the reason we didn't call him Johnny Football was because he was an incredible baseball player. And he could have played basketball if he wanted to play basketball. And you ought to see him hit a golf ball. If you see him hit a golf ball, he could just knock it off the planet.
I hear they call him Johnny Football now in Aggie land, and probably a pretty good moniker. I mean, the kid's a competitor. I think the thing when you look at Johnny, the biggest things I see is he's a competitor. He's a leader, and he wants to win. And he makes people around him better, I think. Doesn't mean he doesn't fall and doesn't fail from time to time. Nobody's perfect, but he holds himself accountable and he'll hold his teammates accountable. And to me, that's what leadership is.
Johnny's leadership was special this year. He set the SEC record for total offense in a season with 4,600 yards and twice broke the single-game SEC record for total O.
He accounted for a total of 43 touchdowns and was a finalist for both the Davey O'Brien and the Maxwell Awards, which earned him a trip to Orlando on December 6th. But he wasn't alone. Offensive lineman Luke Jokel was one of three finalists for the Outland Trophy.
Texas A&M had never won either of the three awards, but on December 6th, both players made Aggie history.
Two out of three, not too shabby for Texas A&M tonight. Luke Jokel wins the first Outland Award in Texas A&M history, while Johnny Manziel brings home the Aggies' first O'Brien Award.
Very good way to start the award ceremony, and hey, my birthday. We've had a great day so far. I got to play some golf earlier, but to win any award here, what a absolute honor. It's unreal. This feeling that I've got right now to win with all these other quarterbacks are here, it's absolutely surreal to say the least.
This is huge, you know. It's a blessing. You know, it's nerve-wracking the whole day. But my dad, you know, he instilled offensive line stuff in me, and you know, Outland is the ultimate goal of an offensive lineman. And, you know, I can remember in Pee Wee football, he was our coach and teaching us to grab the breastplate. You know, taught us how to hold early and stuff like that. But you know, it's. I mean, he's been my best teacher, my best mentor, my dad, and I got to think, you know, I can't believe it. Can't believe tonight.
While Manziel does not win the Maxwell, he can take solace in the fact that five out of the past six O'Brien winners have gone on to win the Heisman Trophy. We now check in with Daryl Bruffett, who caught up with Aggie head coach Kevin Sumlin.
Thanks, Cody. Obviously a big night for Texas A&M. Johnny Manziel wins the Davey O'Brien, and Luke Jokel wins the Outland. Head coach Kevin Sumlin, boy, you got to be a proud papa tonight.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's kind of like these fireworks going off back here in the background. It's one of those kind of nights. A lot of hardware, and a lot of firsts for Texas A&M, like we've been talking about all year. You know, first freshman to win the Davey O'Brien and the first Outland. I mean, it's a big deal.
For Luke Jokel, he sat there and he said, well, maybe there's another guy that won that, because they didn't exactly get Luke Jokel's name out correctly.
Well, I was giving Will a hard time. He said that the teleprompter stopped and they didn't have a name on there. He froze, and I said, well, did you just guess? He said, I'm not going to get into it. But, yeah, we knew who it was. He got to it in a way, but I'm happy for the Jokel family and everybody else. I think the guys said it correctly. You know, there are a lot of great players in this room, but most of them are on winning teams, and all these individual awards are due to a lot of talent individually, but a lot of hard work and the process collectively, and you know, it's a great time to be an Aggie.
But it was just the start of a great 48 hours for the Maroon and White. Friday morning, Johnny Manziel headed to New York City for the Heisman Trophy festivities. And a bizarre thing happened to us at JFK Airport.
While we didn't have any problem shooting Johnny and Luke on their arrival at the Orlando International Airport, we weren't as fortunate in New York. We arrived about an hour ahead of Johnny and were hoping to shoot an interview with him as he came off the plane. Only the Port Authority told us no, forget about it. In Orlando, an FBI agent didn't have an issue with us talking to Johnny. But then again, it might have been because he was an Aggie.
The Port Authority Bulldogs, not as obliging, but when one door is shut, another door is always opened. 24 hours later, we were granted exclusive access to Johnny, Notre Dame linebacker Manti Te'o, and Kansas State's Colin Klein as they prepared to tape a halftime piece during the Army-Navy game, seen right here on KBTX.
Yeah,
that looked
cool.
Are you escorting us?
Yeah,
I'm we'll take you guys up.
Thank you. Sorry.
I brought the trophy on the plane with us
when I was in the airport.
Oh, really?
Oh, wow. Have you ever seen it yet?
No, not in person.
You'll see it.
Nice.
You'll see it.
You'll see it. You can bring him in, and then maybe I guess maybe he can do it on the set.
It's not cool in front of your friends to get makeup, but we'll make it shameless.
Sure.
We'll just do a little patter. Is that all right with everyone?
I like some eyeshadow.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm kidding.
Hey, listen, you know, be careful what you ask for.
Johnny, put your phone away.
And you'll be talking with Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman, and Aaron Taylor. Aaron has a little lineage with you, man. Talking about
yep.
A little golden domer.
You know what? I'm going to just put a little bit of foundation on you. So what's your schedule like today, guys? All over the place?
I think after this we get some downtime.
Oh, all right. So what are you going to do in New York City downtime?
Walk around a little bit.
And do some shopping?
Maybe. What I'm going to do when I get back.
What?
I will sleep, wake up, work out, go to sleep, wake up, get ready. I'm gonna watch you and Colin fight for the Heisman.
Okay, gentlemen over here, just gonna get a couple of shots that we can use promoting you at halftime.
When you listen to Johnny speak, it's pretty clear that the kid is a bright kid, was raised right, and is under a system with Coach Sumlin that really has taught him how to be able to be humble and address the media. And he's the type of kid that, as a former offensive lineman, I would love to have been able to play for. I played with Brett Favre. He reminds me of his improvisation, of some Brett Favre-esque techniques that he has. But the bottom line is, I think Coach Sumlin's decision, which is a team decision and something he did all the way back to his days at Houston, of not letting freshmen speak, actually is what has allowed Johnny Manziel to be in New York in the first place, because he didn't have to answer all the questions and deal with all the peripheral stuff coming down the pipe. So I think it was a great decision. I think it actually helped him have a chance to win tonight.
Did Aaron Taylor say, have a chance to win tonight? He nailed it. The former Notre Dame offensive lineman knew Johnny's numbers were just too much for even his fellow Golden Domer to overcome.
Later that night, Johnny Manziel became Texas A&M's second ever Heisman Trophy winner, joining John David Crow in that exclusive fraternity. Here's a look back at our coverage of that historic night in Aggie football history.
2012 winner of the Heisman Memorial Trophy is Johnny Manziel.
You just can't hear that enough. It is a historic announcement. Manziel becomes the first freshman to ever win the award and the second Aggie to do so, joining John David Crow, who won the Heisman for Texas A&M in 1957. After Manziel won the award, he gave a pretty amazing acceptance speech. He thanked his whole team and mentioned his entire offensive line by name. Manziel also talked about Joey Villavicencio, who was killed in a car accident about this time last year. He said, quote, Mr. and Mrs. Villavicencio, if I had a son, I would want him to be exactly like him. He ended his speech with, quote, to the 12th man, to Texas A&M, Kerrville, Texas, and Aggies everywhere, this Heisman Trophy is for you. Gig'em. Daryl Bruffett and Cody Coyle continue our coverage of this historic night from New York City.
John, you are right, a very heartfelt acceptance speech by Johnny Manziel, the 78th Heisman Trophy winner. Cody, we have been on quite a ride the last 4 days.
That we have, and just think of what Johnny's been going through, going to Orlando and back here to New York to get all of his awards. He said he never really was nervous on the football field, and that's hard to believe with what he did at Alabama, being a true or being a freshman going to places like that. Tonight, he said this is the most nervous that he has ever been, and there is definitely a reason for that. He also was able to talk about the fact that after this, it's going to be back to business and trying to win the Cotton Bowl and getting ready for some very, very high expectations for next season.
I felt my heart like beating out to right here, and I was really wondering on TV if you could see my shirt moving. I don't know if anybody caught that, but I was really, really nervous, more nervous than anything I've ever experienced in my life. Just the suspense that ESPN creates. They do a great job. They do a great job, and they do a great job with the whole Heisman ceremony, so they really got my emotions flowing and really got my heart beating pretty fast. Just me being able to break that barrier, it's such an honor. It's so humbling for me to be the first freshman to win and really make history. I can't explain it because it just truly is so awesome, something I'm so humbled by. But for kids who come out of high school and into college, it doesn't matter what year you are. It doesn't matter if you're a freshman, true freshman. I guess that's the next thing that there is to do. But it doesn't matter who you are if you work hard enough and you have a great group of guys and a great university and great people around you, then great things can happen.
You're a redshirt freshman. You win the Heisman. What else is there to accomplish left in your college career?
Plenty of things. First and foremost, right now, it's the Cotton Bowl. You look to go 11-2 in your first year in the SEC and win a bowl game against a traditional powerhouse. And then from there, I have to be the guy that starts the motor and starts everything for the run to the national championship next year, and that's going to be our team goal. Hopefully, when we get back in the locker room after the season ends, that'll be our motto. That'll be what we do in the weight room, is pushing towards the national championship. And if more individual awards come, that's not really my focus. My focus is bringing a national championship to Texas A&M.
He's been Johnny Football all season long, but as Steve touched on earlier, there's already a billboard up here in Times Square that has him a new nickname they might be working on.
Yeah, Johnny Heisman. It was really funny. You and I were out here on Times Square when they actually made the announcement that Johnny Manziel was the new Heisman Trophy winner. We had folks from Maine. We had folks from Arizona. We had folks from Connecticut. Some folks that really didn't have any connection whatsoever to Texas A&M, and they said, Johnny Football, Johnny Football. They all know about Johnny Football now.
Yep,
but, of course, there's a lot of folks that knew Johnny Manziel before the nickname of Johnny Football came along, and, of course, they could not be any prouder at this time.
This is his night, and this it's about this team. There's a lot of firsts that have happened at Texas A&M this year. And from us going to a new league, from us playing, from new coaches coming in, new system, guys moving positions, choosing a new guy, and him making it all work. Tonight's about him, but it's also about our team. And at Texas A&M, we couldn't be happier for what has happened this year, our first year in the SEC.
We started out this process just trying to win a game and just watching him develop and the way he's worked at it and grown, not only on the field, but the things you see behind the scenes as a man has been the most impressive. So we'll just keep getting better. Lots of room to improve, right?
Sure.
We'll keep getting better and try and you know, improve as a team next year.
It's just such a great, great thing to happen in Texas A&M and the school that we all love so much.
John David Crow grabbed me before it, and he goes, "We're taking that thing home, son." He said, "If you just wait here, Mom, we're gonna take it home." And sure enough, he did it, and here we go.
Unbelievable. I can't tell you how proud we all are of Johnny and Texas A&M. If you would have seen the faces and the tears and 55 years, I can't believe it, but Johnny did such an incredible job tonight. All season long, he showed his heart, but tonight he showed his true faith and compassion for Texas A&M, and I think it was probably one of the sweetest speeches I've ever seen. Did an incredible job, and I can't tell you how excited we are for Johnny and the family.
It was just amazing, and I cannot say enough. You fall in love with these guys up there on that stage and their families, and you want them all to win, but there can only be one, and I'm so thankful it was Johnny, and it's a blessing, and I'm so glad for Texas A&M. They deserve it.
Aside from winning the national championship, this is about as good as it gets for the program, you know. National recognition, everybody wants to get on board, so it's pretty sweet.
Matt and his wife just happened to be in New York City on business, and they just happened to take in the fact that Texas A&M now has their second ever Heisman Trophy winner, and he is exactly right. The Heisman is nearly as great as winning a national championship, but that is the next thing on head coach Kevin Sumlin's radar now.
We heard from key players in Johnny's inner circle as head coach Kevin Sumlin, former offensive coordinator Cliff Kingsbury, and 1957 Heisman Trophy winner John David Crow.
His dad, Paul, his mom, Michelle, and fashion icon, Uncle Harley Hooper. While they were beaming ear to ear, they had every reason to.
What amazed us was the number of people who were pulling for Johnny right there on Times Square, just because they had caught Johnny Football fever.
They just put it up on the billboard, John. Johnny Manziel brings home the Heisman Trophy. Plenty of happy Aggies here on Times Square. Did you ever think your school would have another Heisman winner?
Well, yes. And, you know, the SEC's been really good to us, but it took guys like Johnny Football to get us there.
He deserved it, didn't he?
He really did, without question. And he's a freshman. We got a couple more great years for him. That's going to be exciting.
He's awesome.
He's awesome.
He's Johnny Football, baby, and he's the best. Giga Baggies. Woo!
We think it's great.
He deserved it.
First freshman.
All right. Yay, Johnny.
Congratulations, Johnny.
Keep it going, Johnny. We love you. We'll be watching you for years to come.
We came up here just for this. We're awfully proud. Yeah, Aggies do that kind of thing.
Now, while we were chasing down reaction over 1,000 miles away from perfect strangers, there were plenty of fans back here in Aggieland that had more of a vested interest in the outcome.
Our news department ran across an Aggie student that put together this video from a lot of their reactions around Bryan College Station and across the state. Chuck Berry's 1959 tune, Go Johnny Go, is a popular tune around Aggieland.
Winner of the Heisman Memorial Trophy is Johnny Manziel.
While it took a lot of running for Johnny Manziel to win the Heisman, since becoming the 78th recipient of college football's most prestigious award, Johnny has been on the hop even more.
He has made appearances on CBS This Morning, Good Morning America, Fox and Friends, been on ESPN more than the New York Yankees and Boston Red Sox during his September pennant run. He has made stops on syndicated radio shows, Mike and Mike in the Morning, The Jim Rome Show, and The Dan Patrick Show. Late Night TV has also gotten a piece of Johnny, too. He got a chance to sit alongside Megan Fox as a guest on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno. And less than 48 hours after claiming the most recognized statue in all of sports, Johnny was counting down David Letterman's top 10 perks to winning the Heisman Trophy.
And the number one perk of winning the Heisman Trophy, ladies and gentlemen, my passport photo looks like this.
It has certainly been a memorable moment in time for the Texas A&M football team, Aggie fans, and of course for Johnny Manziel and his family.
And of course for us as well. Cody, you and I talked about on our way home from New York City, we'd always hoped about covering a national championship in football. Never did we dream about going to New York and covering a Heisman Trophy winner.
There is one bit of unfinished business this season, the Cotton Bowl. January 4th against Oklahoma. We'll go in-depth and preview the showdown against the Sooners January 3rd right here on KBTX at 6:30.
That'll wrap up Manziel's Road to the Heisman. So long from the Kentmore Cabinets Digital Studios here at KBTX Media in Bronx.